الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على النبي لا بعد. To proceed, I want to share some quick advice concerning a topic that I believe has its importance and it's a benefit for all of us to come to know this. And for those who already know, it's a reminder, inshallah. وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind, for verily the reminder benefits the believer. And this has its relevance to recent times. For verily, there are some misconceptions about the sect Ikhwan al-Muslimin, and is it binding upon us to regard them as a deviant sect or not? So I thought to share something of a benefit. There's some words of Sheikh Sulaiman al-Ruhili of some research that he did. I've thought it was beneficial to share this along with some other statements of our scholars concerning this topic, inshallah.
هل وجود فتاوى لبعض العلماء في عد جماعة الإخوان من جماعات الدعوة الإسلامية القريبة من الحق إشكال على ما يقرره غيرهم من العلماء؟
So the Sheikh, he mentioned, is the fact that there's some old fatwa from some of the scholars that state words that are different from what other scholars have said concerning the sect or the group, Jama'at al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin. Is that problematic as to what they have uttered? So we'll see the answer of the Sheikh, or we hear the answer.
من خطورة هذا التنظيم وبدعيته وعظم شره والجواب لا شك أنه توجد فتاوى قديمة قليلة في هذا الشأن إلا أنها لا تشكل على ما أشرنا إليه لأن الذاكرين لخطورة تلك الجماعة قد ذكروا وبينوا ودللوا ومن حفظ حجة على من لم يحفظ لا.
So the Sheikh, he mentioned that concerning those who uttered words from some of the mashayikh, or some of the, there be a verdict or a fatwa that goes against the statements of renowned scholars that have warned from the harm and the danger of Ikhwan al-Muslimin. He mentioned that those verdicts, those fatwa, they are small in number, very rare, and also they're old, many of them. So he mentioned that they do not hold weight against what the other scholars have clarified concerning the group of Ikhwan al-Muslimin. But really they have came with evidence and concrete, substantial facts against that testify against this group of its khutura, its harm and its danger.
وأن تلك الفتاوى قديمة قبل تكشف كثير من الحقائق عن هذه الجماعة وعن شرها.
He said, especially being the case that those verdicts, those fatwa, they are qadima, they're old. Before the state of this group, this sect, Ikhwan al-Muslimin, became clear and manifest.
وَقَدْ أَفْتَى كِبَارُ الْعُلَمَاءِ بِأَنَّهَا مِنَ الْفِرَقِ الضَّالَّةِ.
And he mentioned the senior scholars have given a verdict that this sect, Ikhwan al-Muslimin, they are from the deviant sect, the misguided sect.
قال علامة مصر أحمد محمد شاكر رحمه الله حركة الشيخ حسن البنا وإخوانه المسلمين الذين قلبوا الدعوة الإسلامية إلى دعوة إجرامية هدامة ينفق عليها الشيوعيون واليهود.
So he quoted Allamatul Masr, the great scholar, the prominent scholar of hadith, Ahmed Shakir. He described this sect to be a sect that altered and changed the call of Islam to a call of that which is of crime and mischief and destruction. And he mentioned that communists and the Yahud have funded some of their works.
ينفق عليها الشيوعيون واليهود كما نعلم ذلك علم اليقين. وسئل الشيخ ابن باز رحمه الله عز وجل في آخر حياته قبل موته بسنتين سماحة الشيخ, حركة الإخوان المسلمين دخلت المملكة منذ فترة وأصبح لها نشاط واضح بين طلبة العلم, ما رأيكم في هذه الحركة وما مدى توافقها مع منهج أهل السنة والجماعة؟ فقال رحمه.
So he mentions now that Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah was asked 2 years before his death about the group Ikhwan al-Muslimin, since they became widespread into Saudi Arabia. So what is their methodology and what they stand upon?
الله حركة الإخوان المسلمين ينتقدها خواص أهل العلم لأنه ليس عندهم نشاط في الدعوة إلى توحيد الله.
So he mentions that the Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah stated that this movement of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, that the specifics of the scholars, a group of those scholars specialized in the matter of investigation, have criticized and critiqued this group since they don't call to Tawheed. They don't give much attention in their call into this aspect.
وإنكار الشرك وإنكار البدع لهم أساليب خاصة ينقصها عدم النشاط في الدعوة إلى الله وعدم التوجيه إلى العقيدة الصحيحة التي عليها أهل السنة والجماعة. فينبغي للإخوان المسلمين أن تكون عندهم عناية بالدعوة السلفية, الدعوة إلى توحيد الله.
So it's a long verdict has been translated. These statements that the Sheikh is going to read and also what has passed. It's a pamphlet that has been posted on the website, torontodawah.com, for those who wish to return back to it. We're just going to briefly share highlights from it. It mentions that they lack the call of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, their methodology in having the importance of the call of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is something that Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah mentioned that scholars have criticized them for.
وسئل رحمه الله عن حديث افتراق الأمة هل تدخل فيه جماعة التبليغ وجماعة الإخوان المسلمين؟ فقال رحمه الله نعم تدخل في الاثنتين والسبعين, ومن خالف عقيدة أهل السنة دخل في الاثنتين والسبعين.
And also he mentioned that Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah was asked, does this group fall under the 72 sects that comes in the hadith? So he said yes, concerning Jama'at Ikhwan al-Muslimin, and also he was mentioned the question, Jama'at al-Tabligh.
قال السائل مؤكدا يعني هاتان الفرقتان من ضمن الاثنتين والسبعين؟ قال نعم.
And then the questioner, to confirm with the Sheikh, he says, does this mean that these two groups are from the 72 sects? So Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah confirmed by saying yes. So this is the stance of Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah before he died. Many of the old verdicts has been clarified with his later stance. And also many of the other scholars have taken a similar stance, clarifying. Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, he has a verdict and a written article with his signature recanting from a previous statement about Ikhwan Muslimin, and he clarifies that they are not considered from Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that they're a deviant sect. And he also mentioned that they're from the 72 sects that are under the threat of being in the hellfire, generally speaking. So this is something to remember. Also, we know that many other scholars, Sheikh Muhammad Saleh Al-Uthaymeen, there's a number of clips of his later stance warning from this sect, and other scholars that were part of Lajmat al-Da'ima, the permanent committee for verdict. We've noticed that some people may use an old verdict. Many of them have later on released verdicts clarifying that they're not from Ahlus Sunnah wa Jama'ah, and that they're considered a deviant sect. So we're going to play another clip of importance that it requires to be shared just as a benefit, inshallah.
بعد الحق إلى الضلال أبعد ما سمعنا هل يحق لنا أن نثني على هذه الجماعة؟
So after a long lecture, Sheikh Saleh Al-Suhaymi, where he reads from their works and some of their treaties of their leader and some of their core members, he says, after we've heard what we heard, could someone come and praise them, let alone ascribe to them?
إن من شعارات سيدهم حسن البنا قوله أو قوله إن الخلاف بيننا وبين اليهود ليس خلافا دينيا وإنما هو خلاف اقتصادي خلاف اقتصادي.
So he mentions that from the renowned statements of their leader Hassan al-Banna is that our khilaf, our difference with the Yahud, is not a difference in a matter of religion, but it's a difference of that which is economically based, of economics. So this is something affirmed, and there's other reports to show some of the belief of this, of their founder. And we're going to read more about this group, of what the scholars have said. You would see that Sheikh Albani rahimahullah, he also, from the scholars that later on when this group, their stance and their ideologies have became manifest and clear, he was from those who uttered, it is not correct that it said that the Muslim Brotherhood are from Ahlus Sunnah. And he mentioned that they have 70 years, يحاربون السنة, 70 years, and they're waging war against the Sunnah. How could they be from Ahlus Sunnah? So this is the verdict. There's a number of statements that we can read of scholars from different parts of the world. Sheikh Abdul Musa Abad, Sheikh Mubil, Sheikh Saleh Al-Luhaydan. We can go on and on. Sheikh Muhammad Aman Al-Jami. Scholars that have passed away, scholars that are alive. If we could say majority, if not all of the renowned scholars, they have clarified that this is a deviant sect, and they have written publications and clarified in lengthy lectures from their own works and from their beliefs. For to leave, to disregard all of that due to the slightest of doubt, or to say because some of the scholars have not unanimously agreed, well, we can use that for many other groups that we deem deviant. we could perhaps find that there's not an ijma' concerning the Sufiyya or some of their branches. We could perhaps find some who may call to having a bond with the Shia, of who they may, some people may, for example, consider these people to be ulama who call that. So this is something to pay attention. So we should never say that what is, when it becomes binding is when there's an ijma'. We should know that what is mainly our concern is when reality and facts attest to that our sect is deviant. There then we follow the proof and the evidence. This is upon us. For verily we know that there was even some scholars that wasn't maybe clear to them the condition of Osama bin Laden. So are we going to use that there's not an ijma' about Osama bin Laden for us to not to deem him as a deviant? No, we know that his actions attest that he was a deviant and far from correct guidance. So the next statement I wanted to address is what some people use, that some of the members of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the past kings, praised them or supported them. Well, that's not our evidence. For verily, the case can be that it wasn't clear. For verily, it was all, at that those times, many of their ideologies and their agendas wasn't clear. But they were from other kings that stood against them and some of what they were calling to. And I'll give you an example of that.
البنا جاء إلى الملك عبد العزيز رحمه الله وقال له أيها الملك نريد أن نفتح مركزا أو فرعا بمكة للإخوان المسلمين فقال له بأي كتاب أم بأية سنة.
So Hassan al-Banna, the leader, he came to Malik Abdul Aziz, one of the oldest of kings for Saudi Arabia, saying that he wants to open a branch in Saudi Arabia for the Ikhwan al-Muslimin. So he replied, the king, based upon what book and what sunnah.
نَحْنُ فِي بَلَدِنَا هَذَا كُلُّنَا إِخْوَانُ مُسْلِمُونَ مَا هُنَاكَ حِزْبُ اسْمُهُ الْإِخْوَانُ مُسْلِمِينَ لَيْسَ هُنَاكَ حِزْبٌ يُسَمَّى بِالْإِخْوَانِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ لَأَنَّنَا عَلَى قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ على منهج علمائنا على منهج السلف الصالح.
So that king of Saudi Arabia at that time responded to him by saying that we are all Ikhwan Muslimin. There's no such thing of a specific party of Ikhwan al-Muslimin. We are all upon one heart, adhering to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there he rejected this idea that he had. So to be fair, if a person wants to mention a ruler, a specific ruler, he should mention all of them and clarify the majority were against them. And maybe a specific ruler at a specific timing didn't know about their agenda and their ideologies. Another thing that I wanted to clarify is that some may use the stance of Shaykh Ibn Jibreel, rahimahullah, concerning Jama'atul Ikhwan al-Muslimin. This particular scholar, he fell into an error in this regards. And a group of the scholars, majority of our ulama, have clarified generally in contrast to what he has said, whether it be about him giving a title that there's an existing group called Jamia, or some of the words that he said about Hassan al-Banna and Sayyid Qutb of high praise that they don't deserve, or certain wordings that he mentioned about Ikhwan al-Muslimin. Many scholars have said opposite to it, and some have actually specifically sent him advice and advised them, some of them advised them publicly. So it's upon us not to follow a scholar in his error, especially when it becomes manifest and clear. And I'll read that Sheikh Ibn Jibreen, he had a stance that was different from many scholars, that we shouldn't follow him in his error. I'll give you an example of what he said concerning the Asha'ira.
كثير من الأزهريين على العقيدة في الأشعرية وكثير من في المملكة من العلماء على عقيدة في الأشعرية فهل يقال إنهم في النار هذا لا يقوله مسلم.
He mentions that the many from the Azhari Mashayikh are on the belief of the Asha'ira, and he said many from the scholars of the Mamlaka of Saudi Arabia have the belief of the Ash'ari. And some scholars, such as Sheikh Ahmed Ajmi, responded to this. It's not correct to say many. But he's addressing this statement that to say they're all in the hellfire. Yes, this is a wrong statement to be absolute like that. We may say generally they're under the threat to have a corrupted belief. He goes on to speak.
عندهم هذا المعتقد ولهم وجهتهم ولهم نظرتهم وهم أئمة كثير من المتقدمين والمتأخرين.
He mentions that the Asha'ira, they have their belief, their mu'taqad, and they have their wujha, their point of view, and they have their imma, their imams. So we know this is an error from the Shaykh. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him and have mercy upon him. But we should not follow him in his error. And we know that the truth is greater than men, no matter how great a scholar is. Also, his statement about Jama'at Tabligh, we should not follow him and concerning that topic as well.
Alhamdulillah. Sheikh Abdullah Jibreel.
Naam.
يا شيخ ودي أسألك عن جماعة الأحباب إيش رأيك بهم يا شيخ
إن شاء الله أنهم أحباب.
So a man asked him about the group جماعة التبليغ. What's your opinion about them? He says إن شاء الله they are أحباب, they're beloved, meaning beloved to us.
أنهم أحباب يا شيخ
نعم أنهم على خير إخوان على الحق إخوان.
He says they are brothers upon goodness, upon the truth.
الله أكبر الله أكبر شيخ. طيب شو رأيك بخروج الخروج؟
نعم في فوائد.
فوائد.
He was asked, "What do you think about doing خروج with them?" He says, "Yes, there is some benefit."
نعم.
الله يجزاك خير يا شيخ. يعني إن شاء الله بها من شيخ.
إن شاء الله.
الله يجزاك خير طول عمرك يا شيخ.
So he asked him, do you advise for us to join them? He said, yes. So we know this is also an error. It's made clear to many of the Muslims that the group Jama'at al-Tabligh has with them deviation. And if the Sheikh, maybe articles or certain things were to become clear to him, perhaps he would have warned from them, because we know he has on his fatawa, he warns from the Naqshbandiya, he works from many of the turuq of Sufiya, the Qadiriya, the Shadiliya, many of them, where some of the Jama'at al-Tabligh, many have connections to them. So we perhaps make excuse for the Shaykh. At the same time, we don't follow him in this era. So it's similar. What he said about Ikhwan al-Muslimin, we do not follow him in such an error. I wanted to play next the statement of Sheikh Mubir Rahimullah concerning Sheikh Ibn Jibreen about some of his verdicts and his stance.
قديما حديثا أو مستحدثة قديمة كانت أو مستحدثة
ابن جبرين
ابن جبرين رجل فاضل.
So the Sheikh, he was asked, what do you know about Ibn Jibreen, past and present? So he started off by mentioning he's a virtuous man.
نعم ومن أهل السنة حفظ الله تعالى إلا أنني أخبرت أن أولاده مع الحجبيين فربما ماذا ربما يجرونه إلى الحجبيين.
So he mentioned that he's from Ahlul Sunnah, may Allah preserve him. He said, except that I've been informed that his children are people known for Hizbiyyah, biased partisanship. So he says it is feared that they may pull him into such methodology.
وهذا أمر مطلوب جمع الكلمة لكن تحت ظل الكتاب والسنة وما اختلفتم فيه من شيء فحكمه إلى الله.
So he said it's come to me letters from him calling to unity. He said that is a good affair, but that should be in accordance to the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he recited the verse.
فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر.
Reciting the verse says that if you differ, then return it back to the book of Allah. And if you have any disputes, then it should return it to Allah and His Messenger.
وأما أننا ماذا أننا نمشي مع الديمقراطيين ومع الحزبيين ونتنال عن السنة فلا لا لا. وأنا متأكد أنه لو يره مجموعة من إخواننا أهل السنة وشرحوا له دعوة أهل السنة وما يقومون به وما يقوم به ماذا الحزبيون أنا متأكد أنه يغير ما يعني يلقى إليه والله المستعان.
So he mentioned that is the affair is not that the people join along with those who call to democracy and the people of Hizbiyyah. He mentioned also, the Sheikh, that if he were to see, Ibn Jibreen were to see, and the brothers were to come and clarify the realities of the da'wah of Ahl-Sunnah and what the people of Hizbiyyah are doing, there then he would change his stance about certain affairs. So this is what we believe. We give excuses for the Sheikh upon his error, and we know that a group of scholars have advised him, and some of them have been private, some of them publicly. So it's upon us not to follow the Sheikh Ibn Jibreen in this error. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him and have mercy upon him. But us as being alive, we are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and are held responsible for our actions to follow the truth wherever it lies. So this is just a short benefit